Hey guys, we are going to start out in mountain pose. The majority of class tonight is going to be all standing. It's a little bit of gentle flow and some deep stretch moves. Like always, listen to your body. Do what fits best for you right now, not the you who you were a while back or the you who you hope you're going to be in the future. Let's just honor and respect and love ourselves right here, right now. So we're gonna stand up nice and tall. Check in with your feet. Where do they feel comfortable? Toes spread wide. A little bit of space in between your feet or no space. You can bring those big toes together and a little bit of a narrower base. It's completely up to you, whatever feels comfortable. Inhale those shoulders up towards your ears and then roll your shoulders down your back. Turn your palms slightly forward. Not a very militant stance per se, but the hands just slightly forward. Shoulders are drawn back, but soft and relaxed at the same time. You can find a place to rest your gaze. You can close your eyes. Just make sure that those knees aren't locked out. Maybe you have a little bit of pressure with your feet down into the mat and turned out away from each other just slightly. You're not actively lifting your feet and turning them away from each other. You're just pressing down and having a slight turn, more of the skin than the musculature. Take a big breath in. Exhale out. Let your collarbones drop, let your shoulders drop. And I'd like you to ask yourself, what would you like from your practice today? Is there a feeling you're going for? Is there just a decompression, a space from the world, connection with yourself, your body, your breath, the movement? You're not really sure, you're just showing up, and I think that's amazing too. Whatever feels good to you. Take a big deep breath into an answer or the question itself. What do I want out of my practice? Exhale all the way out. And maybe if that question doesn't ring true to you or if there's no connection to it, maybe you can come up with a mantra, a word or a short phrase that you repeat to yourself during this practice. A phrase that keeps bringing you back to this present moment as we wander. Oh, I wonder what I'm going to do tomorrow. I wonder what I'm going to teach the kids. I wonder what tomorrow's going to look like. I wonder what work's going to look like. Oh, bringing myself back. I am strong. I am whole. Be here now. Any of those phrases, maybe one of those feels a little more authentic to you. Maybe nothing, and that's great too. Now we're just going to stand up here. Lift your chest a little bit higher, nice proud heart. Inhale in through your nose. Exhale out through your mouth. Inhale in through your nose. Exhale out through your mouth. Zip those lips, inhale in through your nose. Exhale out through your nose. Constrict your throat just a little bit. See if you can catch on to a little bit of ujjayi breath. Inhale in through your nose. Exhale out through your nose. One last time. Connect with those feet to the earth. Feel the energy rise up through your feet all the way up through the very top of your head. Inhale. And exhale out. As you inhale, reach both arms up to the ceiling. Maybe this is time now to flutter your eyes open. Take your right hand long along the side of your body. Connect the palm of your hand to the side of your right leg. And begin to hinge to the right side, bend to the right. Slight crescent shape of your body. Let that right arm drop a little bit heavier. Lift through those left ribs. Press equally through your feet, maybe a little bit more intensely, even through that left foot. Inhale, slide it back to center, arms reach up. Exhale, sorry, I'm so used to practicing with my eyes closed, it's hard not to close my eyes. Left hand comes to your side, hinge to the left. Lift those right ribs, maybe actively press that right foot into the earth. Find the balance and counterbalance. Inhale, center, look up. Exhale, follow that right hand to your thigh this time. Hinge while looking down at your right foot. Try not to forward bend. Try to look more down towards your heel or your ankle. Inhale, center. Exhale, left hand goes down. Follow it with your gaze. Inhale, center. Exhale, hands go to your back. Your chin comes parallel to the earth. Interlace your fingers back behind your back. Elbows bent, draw those shoulder blades back. One option. Arms straighten. Another option. Hands lift up off of your hips. Another option. No matter which one of these you're choosing to do right now, draw or knit or pull together your ribs so that you don't have this huge flare of your chest. Keep them drawn in. Keep your shoulder blades connecting towards each other like they're drawing together with big magnets. And then we're gonna exhale, soften the hands, lower to your glutes, and then release your fingers away from each other. Inhale, arms up. Let's take it to that side bend again. You can keep both arms lifting this time, or you can bring your hand down again. What feels natural and good to your body tonight or today, whenever you're watching this video? I think I've said that in every single video I've taped. See if you can get a little bit lower. Ooh, inhale up. Exhale down. Take it to the other side. Oh, stretch. Press those feet into the earth. Good. This next time around, I'm going to keep my arms lifted. Please don't, because I'm doing something. You do what works for your body. I am, however, going to interlace my fingers above my head just as a reminder to keep my biceps next to my ears. And it's like I'm drawing a line. I always think of, like, have you ever read the book Henry and the Purple Crayon? It's like I'm drawing that line, that purple crayon line, across the ceiling and over to the wall. And then for me, I'll need a little counterbalance, so I press my left hip out to the side. But these are all individual. Your body might do things very differently than mine, so please honor that. Inhale, draw your line back to center. Exhale, over to the left, drawing that line over to the wall. Reaching and opening through your right rib cage, soft bend of the knees. Most of the time, whenever I remind people to do things, it's because I found myself doing it. And I'm a big knee locker outer. That's good English there. So I lock my knees out like that. So you want a little bit of bend. Inhale back to center one more time with that chest expansion. Maybe try something different. Interlace your fingers back behind your back. Maybe even bring your non-dominant pointer finger on top. Little yoga for the brain to try to figure out what that feels like. I'm gonna keep my elbows bent. So when I keep my elbows bent, I kind of actively push on my sacrum. Here's your sacrum right there. So I'm gonna actively push on my sacrum, elbows bent, and open that chest. So hopefully if you can see that side view, that draws the head of my arm bone, the front of my arm bone back instead of leaving it hunched forward. Try to pull it back right there. Okay, and again, knitting or pulling those ribs into each other so that you're not flaring. Notice the difference in my belly when my ribs are flaring. My belly's flaring. I have a big sway of my back. This way it keeps everything safe and in line. And then go ahead and soften. Release your hands, separate those hands. Inhale, arms up to the ceiling. Exhale, big bend of your knees. Arms become soft as you fold yourself over, so that your bellies come to your knees. Bring the backs of your hands to the floor. Drop your head all the way. Tuck your chin into your chest. Bend your knees a little bit more and begin to roll yourself up, stacking vertebra on top of vertebra. Okay, those are the bones in your spine. All the way, shoulders come up to the ears. They roll back and down. All the way into your mountain pose. And then inhale, arms up again. As you exhale, bend your knees, elbows and wrists and fingers and everything are soft as you come over. This time I'm choosing to wrap my hands around my legs. You don't have to choose that same thing. You can stay right here. But I'm gonna choose to wrap my hands, let that head really hang, and ever so slowly, gently working with my breath, I'm gonna straighten my legs a little bit, but I wanna make sure my belly never comes off of my thighs. So the arms are a good reminder to keep that belly and the thighs connected. So I'm only straightening my legs as much as that connection allows me to. Let yourself hang and breathe. Good. Slowly release those arms. And again, tuck your chin into your chest, roll yourself up. We're gonna do one more time. All the way to your mountain pose though, please. All the way to that mountain pose. Then inhale, arms up. And again, exhale. This is our last one. Last one. Hang here, give yourself a moment. Let that head go. Maybe you're shaking that head out. And then on your next inhale, go ahead and begin to straighten your legs a little bit, but I want you to bring the backs of your hands to the mat. If you have any binds under your legs, release them and just sway. It's like you're creating a half circle around your feet. And you're just swaying from side to side. Couple more. Last one. Bring it back to center. Okay? Little bit of bend in the knees, belly pulled into the spine. Take your arms out to the side. Inhale, come up. Woo. Exhale, full on mountain pose. Inhale, arms up. Palms together to heart center. Let's step that right foot back into a high lunge. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, arms come out to the side. And as they come back to palms together to heart center, I'm going to step my right foot up to meet my left. Inhale, left foot back, high lunge. Inhale, arms up to the ceiling. Exhale, arms come down and around, palms together to heart center, left foot steps up to my right. I'm trying to be as smooth as I can in my movement. We're repeating that same movement side to side. Left leg is now back into a high lunge. Stepping it forward. And do one more to each side, high lunge. Last one. Woo, little off balance. And bring it forward. Man, I am off balance on that side. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, swan dive forward, fold hands to the earth. Inhale, step your right foot back. I'm going to move up a little bit. Lower your knee to the earth, belly pulled in. Inhale, arms up. Exhale out to the side. They're going to come down to the floor. You're going to lift your knee and float your right foot up to meet your left. I use that word in particular, float, because I want you to try to be light and soft as you step your foot up. Okay? Inhale, step your left foot back to a lunge. Lower your knee as you exhale. Inhale, arms up to the ceiling. Exhale, hands come out to the side. Down to the floor. Inhale, Left knee lifts. Exhale, left foot comes forward. Inhale, right leg goes back. Exhale, knee comes to the earth. Inhale, arms up to the ceiling. Exhale, hands to the floor. Inhale, right knee lifts. Exhale, right foot comes forward. Inhale, left leg goes back. Last one. Exhale, knee comes down. Inhale, arms go up. Exhale, arms go down. Inhale, lift your right knee. That's my left. Left knee. Exhale, step your left foot up to meet your right. Good. Plant your feet. Inhale, come all the way up. Exhale, all the way back down. Inhale, halfway lift, monkey pose. Exhale, hands to the earth. Inhale, arms come out to the side, all the way up. We're going to repeat that pattern, but we're going to cut it in half. Palms come together to heart center. Inhale, right leg goes back into a high lunge. Exhale. Inhale, arms up. Exhale them around, and you step that right foot up to meet your left. Inhale, left leg goes back. Exhale, hold. Inhale, arms go up to the ceiling. Exhale, one foul swoop forward. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, hold. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, all the way forward. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, all the way out, all of it out. Get all that air out. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, swan dive, forward fold. Inhale, step your right foot back. Exhale, lower your knee. Inhale, arms up to the ceiling. Exhale, hands come down. Inhale, step your right, lift your right knee up off of the mat. Exhale, float your right foot up to meet your left. Inhale, left leg goes back. Exhale, knee to the earth. Inhale, arms up to the ceiling. Exhale, hands to the earth. Inhale, lift your left knee. Exhale, step your left foot forward. This next time we're going to stay, okay? We're going to hold into a lizard stretch. So inhale, right leg goes back. Exhale, knee comes down to the earth and also the top of the foot if you can. Both hands come to the inside of your left foot and go ahead and just heel toe that left foot up just a little bit more to give you space. But we're gonna keep that knee pulled in. We're gonna keep it hugged into your body. So we're not letting it roll open tonight. We're gonna keep it pulled in. And you know, flexibility, it's been a little off lately. So there's a good chance I'm just gonna hold my lizard here for the next minute. Maybe as you exhale more and more, you can bring that elbow to the floor. Ugh, that's about all I can show you. Maybe you can bring both elbows to the floor. Maybe you can take that left arm and wrap it around your left leg and really hug it in tight so you know that you're keeping that knee pulled in tight into your ribs. Or maybe you're with me and you're just hanging right here. Got plenty of stretch. If you have blocks, which I do, they're just way over there, so I'm not gonna grab them. But if you have blocks, you can take blocks or a pillow under your forearms. I'm about a block away from the floor tonight. Blocks would be helpful, okay? So completely up to you and what feels good. We got a couple more seconds to breathe here. Now we're gonna be really diligent in our with the way we're paying attention to our movement. I really want you to focus because this is a really deep stretch, and to just pop right out of it could be harmful to your body. So I want you to take it slow, and we're actually going to transition to pyramid pose from here, if you can believe it. So you're going to curl your right toes under, and you're going to really gently lift that right knee. I'm going to walk my hands back a little bit to just give myself support, and I'm going to take that right foot and do a couple micro hops forward until I can release that right heel to the earth. My left leg is going to straighten. Okay, can you see that? I'm going to shift my foot back in a little bit. Hands come to the mat. I'm going to pull that left hip back so my right hip automatically comes forward. Take a big breath in. And then as you exhale, see if you can let that head go a little bit. Okay, so in your pyramid pose, you're thinking about both hips pointing forward equally to the front edge of your mat. Trying to get yourself in that right comfortable pose for you. Make sure that it is a comfortable seat, that you allow yourself some freedom. You're breathing. Woo! Not locking out that back knee like maybe I was, just saying. One more breath here. Hopefully pyramid pose is feeling pretty darn good to you right about now. Let yourself be just a little bit heavier. And then we're going to inhale, begin to lift your head, look forward. Bend your left knee, walk your hands out in front of you a little bit, and just slowly slide that right foot up to meet your left. Inhale, halfway lift, monkey pose. Exhale, plant your hands to the mat. Inhale, step your left foot back now into a lunge. Go ahead and lower that left knee and the top of your foot to the earth. Bring both hands to the inside of your right leg, and I'm going to heel toe my foot over to the right, make some space for my arms. Okay, really want to keep knee and ankle lined up on that front leg. Okay. See if you can look back. See that left toe a little bit, make sure it's lined up. And we're going to hold it right here in your lizard pose. And again, you guys can lower. I think I want blocks. I want to try to get a little bit lower. So I'm going to grab my block. Keep my knee hugged in. I'm going to bring my forearms down to my block. Whew. Some nights it's just not there. Days or afternoons or mornings. And our job is not to force it. It really isn't. Our job is to let it naturally occur. There's a reason if your body's like, please don't go there, that we don't go there. Our bodies are so smart, and they are giving you so much information all of the time. And especially when you're in your practice, listen to its messages. My body's saying, let's not go there. I'm going to honor that. I'm just going to stay right here for the next couple of breaths. One more breath. Good. And then I'm going to take that right foot and bring it over a little bit. Okay. Curl my left toes under. Lift my left knee. Couple micro hops to get that left leg forward until I can plant the heel down to the floor. Start to straighten my right leg. So I'm transitioning into my pyramid pose. Pulling that right hip back so the left hip will come forward. Taking a big breath in, and then exhale. See if you can let it go a little bit. Noticing how one side may feel tighter than the other side. I'm not saying this side is tighter, but one of the sides is going to feel a little bit different than the other. It's normal and natural and pretty much happens to everybody. I don't know if I know anyone that has gotten away from not having their left and the right side may be different. I think there's a reason. We are asymmetrical beings. I always like it when I can throw in big fancy words. Asymmetrical, big and fancy enough. Keep that right hip pulling back. Breathe deep. Notice where you're feeling your sensations at. Thank you. It's amazing to me how much I will hold myself back from going into my stretch. And maybe you have noticed this about your body too, but I'll take a big breath in and I'll just kind of have this sigh like, oh my gosh, I'm so tired. And all of a sudden my body like gives way a whole nother inch. I was like, oh, didn't know I had that in me. You know, so maybe you've got that too and you don't know. Maybe you try it. Inhale, bring your gaze forward, gently bend your right knee, walk your hands out in front of you a little bit. This gives your body that space to take that left foot forward to meet the right, and maybe even walk your right foot back to meet your left. Bring your palms together to heart center, pull your belly in nice and tight to your spine, draw your shoulder blades back and slowly stand yourself up. Taking your time, we have been over a long time. And mountain pose. Maybe a little bit of a wiggle, maybe a little bit of a shake, okay? Kind of up to you here. All right, so we're gonna have a lot of chest expansion coming up, a lot. So I just want you to honor your body, okay? So we're gonna take and we're gonna step it into warrior one with our right leg back. So go ahead and step that right leg back. So we were just in pyramid pose, same pose, but this time the left knee is bent. Okay, try to pull your low belly in or try to draw the front of your pelvis back just a little bit so that that tailbone lines up kind of in that same line towards the floor as that back right leg. Everything is facing forward. Okay, inhale, arms up to the ceiling. As you exhale, we're gonna reach back. And this very first time around, we're gonna just grab opposite forearms, okay? And then I want you to pull your ribs in just a little bit. We're gonna just hold it right here. Find your breath, feel the sensations. Come back to your question, what do I need for my practice tonight? Come back to your mantra, bring yourself present. Exhale, release. Slide those hands apart, palms back together to heart center. Step your right foot up to meet your left. Inhale, left foot comes back into warrior one. Okay? Inhale, arms up to the ceiling. Exhale, interlace your fingers now back behind your back. Straight arm, squeeze your shoulders together. Pull that front of your pelvis in, that low belly in. Lift your arms. Breathe. Keep your heart open. Open and proud heart. Exhale, bring your hands to your glutes. Slide those fingers apart. Palms together to heart center. Left foot steps up to meet your right. Okay. All right. Inhale, right leg goes back again. Warrior one again. Lots of chest expansion, lots of warrior ones. Sorry, I didn't turn my notifications off. Inhale, arms up to the ceiling. Exhale, bring your hands back behind you. Bend your elbows, squeeze your shoulder blades together. Bring your hands right onto your sacrum. Squeeze it back. Pull that right hip forward. A lot of different dynamic movements happening here in one pose. Breathe into it. You got it. One more breath. Soften your joints. Slide your hands apart, palms together to heart center. Step your right foot up to meet your left. Okay? So far, so good. Hopefully. Told you there's a lot. Opt out when you need to. Left foot comes back. Warrior one. This time we're going to do something a little bit different with our hands. So I'm going to turn my back to you so you can see, hopefully. Okay, so I'm in my warrior one. From here, I'm gonna bring my hands, prayer position, and I'm gonna do everything I can to flip my hands around, get hooked up in my bra, okay, back behind me. Okay, not necessarily a requirement. Now I can't remember which leg was back. Let's say left. I'm gonna pretend. Hopefully I'm right. I'm gonna hold it right here. Woohoo, my wrists are talking something fierce to me right now. They're saying words you're not allowed to say in yoga class. That's what my wrists are saying. Big deep breath. Then my question always is, how am I gonna get out of this? Okay, so you're just gonna soften. You're gonna let them peel apart from each other. We're not doing any forcing. Oh man, palms together to heart center. And step it forward. Whew. Full mountain pose. I need a break before this next one. So stand up nice and tall, big breath in. Exhale all the way out. All right, last one. This time we're gonna bring our warriors a little bit wider than we normally would. Palms together to heart center. Okay, I want you to step your left foot to the left just a teeny tiny bit and take your right foot back behind you but out to the right a teeny tiny bit. So it's like you're trying to be on railroad tracks. Okay, still that right, it's pulling forward. I'm still in warrior one. I automatically went to lunge, but we're in warrior one. Heel is down, hip is forward. Inhale, arms up. As you exhale, bring those hands around. Interlace your fingers back behind you. And again, you can stay right here. You're always, always, always doing what is comfortable for your mind, your spirit, and your body, okay? But if you wanna follow with me, we're gonna take a big breath in. As you exhale, I'm gonna dive forward, leading with my heart. Trying to bring those left ribs to the inside of my left leg a little bit more, a little bit more. And I'm humbling my warrior. Humble, humble, humble. Trusting that higher power, whatever your higher power is. Letting myself humble to the greatness of Mother Earth, Father Sky. Holding it here, breathing into it. Keep trying to pull that left hip back a little bit. It's so hard to do, it's not easy pose. Then inhale, lift your gaze a little bit, press into those knuckles, rise up. Holy moly, separate those hands. Palms together to heart center. Right foot steps up to the left. Yeah, I do a little shake to psych myself up for this last side. Okay, right leg moves over to the right a little bit, right? You've got your warrior ones down by now, I hope. Left leg goes back, and if not, that's perfectly okay too. Left leg's out to the side a little bit. Heel is planted. Okay, hips are pointing forward. Whew, here we go. Inhale, arms up. Seriously, totally psyching myself up to get this done. Interlace those fingers back behind your back. I love it. I love it. But this one brings a little bit of fear into my body when I do this. It's scary to humble yourself forward in so many senses of the word. So I'm going to take a big breath and I'm going to lead with my heart, which I'm trying to do with my life. Man, there are so many lessons I take off my mat. And I'm going to lower, working on bringing my right ribs to the inside of my right legs. Ooh, I only have one right leg, inside of my right leg. Dropping that head, lifting those arms, finding that pose that works the best for you in your body, in your space, in this moment. Breathing. Then I'm going to actively press into those knuckles, lift my gaze slightly so that my neck is engaged, and lift it all the way up. Soften those hands, palms together to heart center, a celebratory left foot steps up to the right, mountain pose. Soften those shoulders. Soften those knees, turn those knees out just a little bit. Lift up tall, proud heart, big breath in. Exhale all the way out. Big breath in. And exhale all the way out. Palms back together to heart center. This time we're going to step our right foot back into a warrior two. So now we're opening up. Okay, palms together to heart center. Right foot steps back, open to that warrior two. Line that left heel, your front heel, up with the inside arch, okay, middle of the arch. Arms out. All right, we're gonna do something fun tonight. You ready for this? Or today, or whenever you're watching this video and recording it at night. We're gonna reverse our warrior, and then we're gonna do revolved reverse warrior, okay? Don't worry, it's safe, I promise. Take that left palm, flip it up to the ceiling, reverse your warrior, so keep actively pressing that left knee forward. Right hand can go to your thigh. It can come across the small of your back and reach over to your left thigh. Can just go right here, a little sassy reverse warrior. Whatever works the best for you. Okay, then we're gonna inhale to warrior two. You're gonna take your left hand over to the back of your left glute. That right arm's gonna sweep forward, flip your palm up to the ceiling, twist your chest forward, and reverse that warrior. Don't lock out that right knee. Breathe here. I'm hoping that there's some sensation occurring in your body here. Taking one more breath in this really odd pose. As you exhale, take that right arm down. Open back up to your warrior two. Palms come together. Soften your joints and step your feet together. Okay, I'm gonna come to the front, the other side of the mat so I can stay facing you. This time we're just gonna switch. So now we're gonna take that left leg back. Open it up to warrior two. Okay, line up that right heel with the inside arch, the middle of the inside arch. Don't lock out your back left knee if you can get it, but not a big bend. And although it's kind of a fun feeling pose, keep that knee straight. Okay, arms straight out the shoulders. Flip that right palm. Reverse your warrior. Don't let that knee come with you. We're keeping it bent. We're staying in warrior tonight. Breathing. Gaze up to the ceiling. Coming back to your question, your word, your phrase. Something to bring you present. Inhale to two. Take your right hand to the back of that right glute. Swing that left arm forward. Flip the palm. Reverse. Revolved reverse warrior on the other side. So I don't know about you, but I will tell you that this feels so awkward and like locked. And I'm wondering if maybe there's a key to unlock this pose for me a little bit more. I have a lot of curiosity with this pose, which is a wonderful thing to have with yoga, curiosity. Exhale, that left hand comes down, back to your warrior two. Palms together to heart center, and gently step those legs together. Oh, mountain pose. Stand up nice and tall, big breath in. Exhale all the way out. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, arms up to the ceiling. Exhale, swan dive, forward fold. Shake your head around. Big deep breath. Exhale, let it go. Let all the worries roll off your back. Okay, even if it's just for a moment, just a moment, let the worries go. All is well right this moment. Even if it's not, I'm not trying to be Miss Sunshine or anything along those lines. I understand the realities of our world. But for a moment, for our nervous system, you can allow to not have any for just a moment. And then on your next exhale, plant those hands, give yourself a nice foundation, and we're gonna slowly come down to a seated position onto your glutes, okay? Oh, bring those legs wide. Sit up nice and tall. Maybe the hands come to the floor. Maybe your hands come to your thighs. Flex your feet. Just find this nice line right here. Everything's lined up. Find your breath. We're going to take our left foot and we're going to pull it into the inside of that right leg. Okay. When you're ready to exhale, twist and turn towards that right foot. Inhale, arms up. I feel a little bit of that reverse revolved warrior here. And then exhale, hands come either to your toes or to the floor, wherever that may be for you. Your chest is drawn towards your toes. Nice line here. I'm gonna try to keep my spine straight for a moment, neutral for a moment or so, till my body can understand where we're going and what we're doing. I'm gonna take a big breath in and then exhale. I'm gonna let my spine round and my head drop. And maybe you don't move anywhere, that's totally fine. Maybe you move a lot, that's great too. What's the best for your body in this moment? What do you need? Breathe here. Give your body permission to relax your muscles, to soften in your joints, to make space. Then inhale, gently bring your gaze up to your toes. Release any grasps that you have and start to walk your hands back. Nice and slow, turn back to center. Take that left leg and go ahead and bring it long. Sit up nice and tall, big breath in. Exhale all the way out. Inhale, take your arms up to the ceiling. Exhale your left hand to the earth. And your right hand to the earth. And gently walk those hands out. I never did a forward fold like that until one of my favorite teachers ever, her name's Jenny Lynn, she did that. That's how she folded forward. And so I stole that from her, I'm admitting it, because I just loved it. I love the way it felt, and I love the way it looked. I love the way it brought me down into the stretch. So that was a move that I've picked up. So cool to see other teachers and check out what's out there. There are so many amazing instructors out there, and they have just sometimes the coolest things. So, you know, check out other videos, check out other teachers. It's really neat right now. And silver lining, Polly Pockets, little sunshine action. It's cool. Well, teachers are offering online things, people you'd never get to take a class from in a million years, or it's hard to take a class from, and we have that option right now. So, you know, see what's out there, check out the teachers. There just are some that will just fill your soul like you never thought possible. And Jenny Lynn was definitely one of those instructors for me, for sure. So, you know, it's just a thought, just check, see what's out there. You got the opportunity now, so take it. All right, let's inhale, walk it back. Woo, nice and slow. Okay, we're gonna pull our right foot now into our left leg. Big breath in. As you exhale, turn to face that left foot. Okay, make sure your chest is lined up. Okay, inhale, arms up. And then exhale, fold. Maybe you can reach your toes. Maybe your hands come to the sides of your legs. Wherever your body goes organically, take it there. Allow your eyes to close. Let's start to settle. Start to get a little bit heavier. As you exhale, release your foot, or if you're holding on to something, go ahead and release it, and then just slowly start to walk your hands back to your body, coming all the way up to center, crossing your left leg in front of your right, sitting up nice and tall. Exhale, take a gentle twist to one side. Gentle twist, please. Inhale, center. Exhale, gentle twist to the other side. Inhale, center. Reach your arms up to the ceiling. Exhale, right hand to the earth. Gentle side bend. This time we're sitting, not standing. Inhale, center. Exhale, left hand comes down. Oh, inhale, center. Exhale, bring your hands down and set them on your knees. And again, come back to your question, what do I need from my practice tonight or today? Or your word, your phrase. Bring yourself back to the present moment. Feel your body. Check in with the sensations. Big breath in. Exhale all the way out. Then let's slowly come onto our backs. Lowering down. Hugging your right knee up towards your right shoulder. And releasing it to the earth. Clunk, clunk. Hug your left knee up to your left shoulder. Slowly release it down to the ground. Okay, take your arms out to the side. Release your knees to the left. Inhale, center. Exhale to the right. Inhale back to center. Okay, a couple options. Hugging knees into your chest, rocking from side to side. Bottoms of feet together, knees open wide. I'm gonna take it into a happy baby pose. My low back and my sacrum have been giving me a little bit of grief. Actually, they always give me grief. So I love happy baby. I love the extension that happens in the lower lumbar, meaning that you take it out of a neutral position and you begin to straighten the lumbar, which is your low back. Those don't normally straighten. Normally they're an extra curvy, which mine are. So this feels really good. And I also feel like it's helpful to reset your pelvis or reset your sacrum sometimes. I'm not saying it will, but every once in a while it kind of feels like it just gives you that little bit of a reset, brings everything back to maybe where it's supposed to be, maybe. Actively pulling down on your feet is also great for the glutes. Kind of pinches those hip flexors. A little compression action happening. Another big deep breath. And then go ahead and slowly release. Maybe just grabbing hold of the shins. Letting those legs come out wide, maybe bringing them in, maybe you make circles around. I don't know, what feels good in your body? What do you need to do? What's asking for? Just a little bit of organic movement. And then we'll slowly make our way down. Legs go straight out in front of you. Arms reach up overhead, full body stretch. And then exhale your arms down to your sides. Walk your shoulder blades underneath you and down your back. See if you can bring your chin just a little bit closer to your neck or to your chest. Make space in your body. Move until it feels you feel good. And then relax. Breathe. Start to deepen your breath. Rock your chin over to your right shoulder. Bring it back to center and rock your chin over to your left shoulder. Bring your chin back to center one more time. Rock it over to your right shoulder. And then back to center, over to the left. Back to center, take one hand to the center of your chest and one hand on your low belly. Actively connect in to your energy right now. Focus on a nice long exhale. Again. Take those hands, slide them across, give yourself a great big hug. Open your arms up and give yourself a hug with your arms in the reverse direction. Slowly release, bringing your knees up and rolling over onto your favorite side. Knees draw up. Head rests on your arm. Eyes closed. See if you can send a little bit of gratitude and some love to all of the cells in your body. All those cells working hard to keep you healthy. Keep sending love to them. And slowly begin to open your eyes. Bring yourself back into the room. Use your hands and your arms to gently press yourself up to a comfortable seat. Take your time to get there. It's no race. Sit up nice and tall. Inhale those arms up to the ceiling. Take in and seal up all of the goodness of your practice. Palms together to your heart center. Gratitude pose. Thank you for joining me. Namaste.